Dear students, welcome back to online learning of subject geography. In previous chapter, we have studied about air pressure. Air pressure is not uniform across the earth's surface. It keeps on changing from time to time. Air moves from high pressure area towards the low pressure area in a horizontal manner. So, winds are generated due to this movement. So today we are going to study geography chapter number 5, winds. What is wind? When hot air rises and creates a region of low pressure, cold air from neighboring high pressure areas move towards the low pressure area. The horizontal movement of the air is called wind. What is high pressure and low pressure? The speed of wind depends on the pressure difference between two regions. When the difference is high, wind rushes from high pressure region to the low pressure region at a great speed. If the difference in the pressure is less, the wind blow with less speed. Wind speed also varies. Wind velocity is measured in the units of knots or kilometers per hour. Winds are known by the direction from which they flow. The direction of winds is influenced by the rotation of the earth. In the northern hemisphere, winds get deflected toward the right of their original direction, whereas in the southern hemisphere, they get deflected towards the left of their original direction. The rotation from west to east causes this change in the original direction of the winds. For example, westerlies are winds that blow from the west. The direction of blowing, the duration, the regions covered, and the condition of the air determine the following wind types. Types of winds are: first, planetary winds; second, local winds; third, seasonal winds. Now, what are planetary winds? The winds that blow from the permanent high pressure belt towards the permanent low pressure belts maintain their directions of flow throughout the year. They are called permanent or planetary winds. Types of planetary winds are the easterlies, the westerlies, and the polar winds. What is easterlies? In both the hemisphere, the winds blow from high pressure area between 25 degree and 35 degrees parallels to the equatorial low pressure belt. Due to the rotation of the earth, their original direction changes. In the northern hemisphere, they blow from the northeast to the southwest, whereas in the southern hemisphere, they blow from the southeast to the northwest. These winds coming from both the sides converge near the equatorial calm belt. These winds are known as the easterlies. What is westerlies? In both the hemisphere, winds blow from the mid-latitudinal high pressure belt to the subpolar low pressure belt situated near 60 degree parallel. Their original direction changes due to the rotation of the earth. In the southern hemisphere, these winds blow from the northwest to the southeast, and in the northern hemisphere, they blow from southwest to the northeast. These winds are called westerlies. What is polar winds? In both the hemisphere, winds blowing from the polar high pressure belt to the subpolar low pressure belt, that is 55 degree to 65 degree, are called polar winds. Generally, they blow from east to west. Winds in the southern hemisphere blow with great velocities. The southern hemisphere is mostly occupied by oceans. In this hemisphere, the obstacle caused by the relief of land surface is almost absent. As there is no obstacle, the winds blow with greater velocities in the southern hemisphere as compared to the northern hemisphere. Their characteristics are as follows. Beyond 40 degrees south, the wind blow with tremendous velocities. These winds are called roaring 40s. Around 50 degrees south, winds are stormy. Hence, they are called furious 50s. The stormy winds around 60 degrees south make tremendous noise and hence they are called screeching 60s. The roaring 40s are extremely powerful westerly winds that blow in the southern hemisphere between latitude 40 degree and 50 degree. These gale force west to east currents are the result of the combination of three variables: warm air movements, the earth's rotation, and the near absence of relevant land masses. The roaring 40s, furious 50s, and screeching 60s are the winds that batter the southern ocean on the fringes of Antarctica. Their names are nods to the latitudes at which they occur in the southern hemisphere and are terrifying in the intensity they evoke, and with just cause, long feared for the devastation they could wreak. Their very existence shaped the shipping routes used by the boats that sailed these waters. Unlike in the northern hemisphere, the winds can blow practically uninterrupted due to the lack of large land masses below 40 degrees south. During the age of sailing ships, sailors would use these strong winds as part of their sailing routes to speed their passage across the Indian or Pacific Oceans.